In this video, we're going to learn how to define new functions. In order to define a function in Racket, you start with a pair of parens, most forms do, and you have a define. Define tells Racket that we're defining something new. In this case, it's going to be a function called, let's say, times 2. We also need to specify the name of the parameter. Let's call it x, just like in math class, where we're defining, let's say, f of x. This is times 2 of x. After giving the name and the argument, or arguments, if there are more than one, we need to specify what the result of the function should be. In this case, we want to multiply 2 by x. In order to multiply things, we knew this already, we just need a pair of parens. The operator comes first, in this case, multiplication, the asterisk. We want to multiply 2 by whatever value x has. And that's how we define a function. Well, what does it produce? It doesn't produce anything. And when we run it, we get this funny black and orange highlighting. What the heck's going on there? That highlighting indicates that this part of the program wasn't used. The reason that that part of the program wasn't used is that we didn't actually call this function. We defined a function, but we never applied the function. In order to apply a function, we use it in just the same way that we use the built-in operators. That is to say, we have a left paren, and then we have the name of the operator, in this case, times 2, the one we just defined, and then an argument. Let's say it's 5. So what should we get when we apply the times 2 function to 5? It's 10. The point of defining a function is that you can use it a whole bunch of times. Times 2 of 45 and times 2 of 89. And we can run this program and multiply all of them by 2. There are no surprises there. It turns out that numbers are not the only kinds of things that functions can produce. Define red square. Let's define a function that produces a red square with a given side, s. Just as before, the thing that comes after the name of the operator and the argument is the body, what it is we want it to produce. In this case, a square with a given side that is solid and red. Let's use that as before, with red square with side 20, a red square with side 40, and a red square with side 60. When we run this program, we get 3 red squares. Now you know how to define a function and how to apply it.